know how to start this particular conversation, but I was seated with a friend of mine and she was trying to script for her TV show, and then she goes like, you know what, the tragedy that just happened on Lake Victoria and all of that, and we were looking at the different stories of survivors and spouses left behind, children left behind, the different reactions. Trust me, it is really, really sad. But on top of being sad, there were some reactions that got us going like, what? So there's this chick, they asked her, she goes like, no, my husband told me he was going for a work-related summit, but come on, I knew he was definitely with his side chick. So when I had a bottle cap size and she was on it, I definitely knew my husband was a goner too. I was like, wait. Now, this to me brought up the question. Since we are millennials and we are doing things how we want, can we look into the fact of making the side chick official? Like, it's possible. You see how married Muslim men have four wives and everybody know each other. So for all of those guys who just don't know how to keep it in their pants and respect their vows and marriage, how about, just saying, how about you introduce your side pieces to your current chicks and tell them, babe, I love you, you have the ring, but there's a side piece too. So at any given moment, we know where he at. If he's with me or if he's not with me, he's with you. If he's not with you, he's with me. It's just one of those random thoughts. Because these stories were too many. But then again, as I was still trying to figure that out, someone was like, Tina, those were side chicks. Not everybody on that boat was a side chick. I'm like, Wanji, I didn't even know any of the people on the boat were side chicks. I just thought this was a group of random people who went out to have fun. And then, well, they kind of brought me into it. And I guess it's that hashtag, if you know, you know. But they were not really side pieces. The whole thing, someone just calls up a couple of girls. They have like a couple of rich guys. The rich guys are like, we need girls to have fun with. So they'll pick up the call and they'll be like, yo, nachimbugwe, nachibwe, tede mwena, rosa, sandra, eh. So there's a middleman, there's a pimp here. Now they're pimping out girls like this, and I didn't even know it until I've started putting faces to it, and I'm like, girls, what happened to girls? Like, so lives were lost. We cannot explain why it happened that way. It was a tragedy. But even in this tragedy, it has brought up so many things that we should ask ourselves. It has brought up living responsibly, loving your life, and loving it so much that you care for it. It has brought up the pimp chronicles, which I am definitely going to follow through with, because yay, it's a racket. Other than that, my name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. The general public's reaction towards Bobby Wine when he did congratulate Bebe Cool. What was your reaction to this? Ooh, did you say he's a pretentious guy? Faruk, what was your take on it? I say mad love. I say mad respect, you know? Because with all that's going on, and this I said the only reason these people are always going to be at their necks and at their throats is because of us, the people. If we give it too much fire, you get what I'm saying? At some point, I believe these two can humble down, eat pie, and, you know, share a couple of things and stay in their own lanes. Bobby Wine will stay in his lane and decide what he's doing, and Bebe Cool will just be Bebe Cool. I felt like this was progressive. Woo, child! Willis had to go and say it. According to Willis, that Bobby Wine's entire congratulatory message, it had just one thing, like keynote, PS. More of the story was he just wanted attention from it. I'm like, what? Are you people trying to make Bobby Wine out now to be an attention whore? I'm personally done. I'm sitting on fences for these two, because anyway, Bobby Wine congratulated Bebe Cool. Nacho tuchite. Let's move forward. I mean, chameleon cut. Bebe Cool. Chameleon ya gambira wambu. Bobby Wine, Bebe Cool na mala winning ya award again. Namu wameka. Bambi, kamiri. Leta kakadeka Bebe Cool. Even if tagenda kaku atakampe. Kati, ya chameleon, that's a congratulatory message. So, chameleon, bring Bebe Cool's 1 milli. Bobby Wine, thank you for that. And Pepe Cool, just thank you for being you and congratulations upon winning your Afrima again. I have to say that, but this is going to be so, so nice. Okay, this is a PSA, public service announcement. For all of you who, I want you to catch up, people. So ever go on social media and find like all these different Slay cartoons and different socialites, you know, like if you visit their pages there with different important people. Have you ever seen that, Willis? Like, you open one Slay Queen's Instagram, standing with Mike Mukula, standing with who? Standing with people that you don't even know, but you have to assume that they're important. And I was like, how do these girls meet all these people? Now, Saturday afternoon, good Lord. A lot happened on the weekend. So Saturday, I'm minding my own business, right? And there was this event that had the French ambassador, and he was supposed to be at the event. He was supposed to press the event. It was held at Cayenne in Bokoto. So I'm chilling, minding my own business, and then a phone call comes through. They're like, Tina, do you always want to know? You've always asked yourself how these girls are always in these important places with these important people. I'm like, yeah, I'm finna know. Let me know. Hey, Jesus. So Bettina, in walks in Bettina and her crew of warriors. When they get to the event, they wanted to come in, so they get to the entrance and they're like, Temmo. They're like, Tuliba media. They're like, media. But why somewhere very moon? I'm sorry, you cannot come in here. And she's like, anyway, has the French ambassador arrived? And they're like, no, he has not. And then she swallows her pride because she knew definitely she did not have a pass to get in. She had no invite. So she sits on the side. You people, she sat there like for about 3 hours. Reason, she was sitting there for about 3 hours. Well, now this is how it works. Only reason she came for that particular event, she came with her personal photographer. Now, the photographer was inside. Now, all she wanted for all those 3 hours of just sitting there and trying to play cool, like, you know, everything is okay, is for the French ambassador to come. I was like, wow, business in Kampala is serious. It's serious. So this is how these girls are building up their resume. It's that simple. Walk around a place, see an important person, snap, snap, put it on your different socials, and guess what? Bam, you're important. Bam, you're endorsing. Bam, you're an influencer. Don't say I didn't give you magazi, by girls. You're out there moving, now it's simple. Get up in the morning with nothing much to do with your life because your life dictates, so don't have your collar. Dress up really good and go look for important people to take photos with. Who knows? You could end up being a Bettina. Hey, younger Bisharia, let's talk comedy. Gati, we bumped into Dolly Wondo. And we were asking if he has this thing going on. He has they're going to do comedy in the world. Nenga comedy, bamutute wala. When I tell him, mute kane kubu bot kubu. So we bumped into him, we're asking him about his, you know, comic situation that's going to be happening, I think, this weekend. And we ask him, Kakati said, what Ugandia? In a particular event, yeah, comics who are legendary. And I thought he was going to support their brother, because you know they're from the same struggle. Ooh, not Dolivodo. I was like, well, you see, yes, this event is entirely for legends, man. Yes, it was among them, just me.
My name is Dolly Wondo and Stressa Babangida. And this Saturday, the 1st of December, we are going to Jinja. The place is called Forever Resort, immediately after the bridge. This was supposed to be a legendary kind of show.
Okay.
And mariachi just featured in, just to spice it up. Otherwise, it's not a legend yet.
Anywho, that's been my beautiful 10 minutes. Yes, people, there are 10. I always at times think like this should be like what you guys always suggest, like 2 hours, full day of just throwing shade. That would be interesting. But hey, it's been my 10. And I have to go. Don't forget, on Twitter, it's at Tina Fierce One. And on Facebook, it's at Tina Fierce One. Or Scoop and Scoop. Like, follow the pages. On Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I love you. Catch you again tomorrow. And do not forget, be safe. Live responsibly. I'm out. Peace.